Boss said that we need some openings in here. Let's make some. Is that good, boss?
Yes, but we need it on the walls, idiot, not on the paper.
Don't worry, I will make it right now. Let's do the things that boss wants. The first tool in openings that we want to learn are biface and vertical. You can find them in architectural tab and in the openings panel. To create them, you need to click on biface, for example. For the biface opening tool, you need to select select a face first. For example, let's select this slow face in here, and then you can create your openings really easily on the face that you've selected earlier. Let's make it smaller and then click on finish, and now you have your openings. Unjoin them, that's not important in here, and now you have your openings in here. The next opening that you can create is vertical. In vertical, you don't need to select your face. You need to select your element. So click on vertical and select the element that you want to create opening in it. And then let's go to the top view to create our opening, vertical opening. And now you can create a shape that you want to create opening in that shape. Now I'll click on unjoin again. And now we have our opening in here. This is a little bit distorted, but don't worry about it. Let's create another vertical opening in here because that was a little bit distorted. Maybe let's create a rectangular one in here. I want to show you the difference between them two. Let's click on finish. And now we have two rectangular opening in here, but there are some difference between them. So let's compare them. After we've learned about the vertical and biface opening, I need to point out some points to you. And that is, for example, when you are creating vertical openings, the edge of the opening will be perpendicular to the level that you have. But when you are creating biface and you have a slope roof, it will be perpendicular to the slope of your roof. And the next tip is, if you don't like this video, Revit won't show anything from these to you.
The next two openings tool that you want to learn are shaft and wall opening. To access them, again, you need to go to the architectural tab, and in the openings panel, we have our shaft and wall opening. For shaft, it is applicable if you have a vertical shaft in your building, for example, your elevator or your stairs, or for example, in parkings, you have some places that you want to create shafts in multi-story dimension. For example, in this building, we have a stair in here and we want to create a shaft in that area. For example, let's go to the 3D section of this stair. You can see we have this situation and we want to simulate a shaft in here. To do that, you can create them in 3D or even in plan. For example, let's go to the entry level, and in here, click on architectural tab. In the opening tab, you have the shaft tool. To create your shaft tool, just pick the boundaries of it. After you've created the boundary, it's time to trim them. Let's press TR and let's trim these lines to close our boundary. It is vital to have a closed boundary. And even before creation or after creation, you have the tools to change the height of the shaft in here. For example, we have a base constraint and top constraint. Let's click on finish. And now let's go to 3D. As you can see, we have the manipulation tools in 3D too. For example, let's bring it a little bit up because I don't want to create a shaft in the first floor or on the ground floor elements. So let's bring it up, and now you can see we have our shafts in here. The next tool that we have is wall opening, and as the name describes, there are some openings in the walls that you want to create, and you can use wall openings in that case. So click on wall opening in here and then select the wall, and now you can create your openings really easily. And even after that, you can move it and you can make it bigger or smaller. But there is a limitation in wall opening, and that is the only shape that you can create with wall openings are rectangular. So if you want to create more complex shapes, you can use wall profiles. If you are wondering why we are not covering the dormer, because I have another video on the channel, and that's about the dormers and roof, and this is vital to learn that too, to understand all of the openings tool in Revit.